Mr. Justice J. Chalmeshwar, Dear Supreme Court of India, Mrs. Chalmeshwar, Honorable Mr. Justice R. K. Agarwal, Honorable Mr. Justice Ashok Bhushan, Judges, Supreme Court of India, my esteemed brother Justice Tarun Agarwal, my learned brother and sister judges of the Allahabad High Court and their spouses, Mr. Raghavendra Singh, learned Advocate General, Additional Advocate General, Chief Standing Counsel, Additional Solicitor General, Dr. L. P. Mishra, President of Avad Bar Association and other office bearers of the association, Principal Law Secretary, Government of Uttar Pradesh, other invitees, learned district judges, additional district judges, Registrar General and his team of registrars, staff of the High Court, print and electronic media, ladies and gentlemen. A very good morning to one and all. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to the inaugural function of this 2 days conference of district and additional district judges of the state of Uttar Pradesh. On 4th and 5th February 2017, we held a conference of civil judges senior division and civil judges junior division in the very same hall, which was attended by about 1200 judicial officers, and it was extremely fruitful. The conference with this structure of the district judges and additional district judges of the state of Uttar Pradesh has never been convened by the High Court before. We are very happy to hold this conference for discussing varied subjects of a procedural and practical nature, which will enable our judicial officers to introspect and improve their performance for the betterment of litigating public at large. I firmly believe that intellectual exchange and dialogue which would occur in this conference will enable our judicial officers of the state to rededicate themselves to the pursuit of suit with renewed vigor and purpose. I welcome you all to the city of Lucknow, a city which is a great history of legacy. Innumerable monuments found across this city are evidence of its unique place in the history of our nation. The new High Court building where we are meeting today in its own right become a significant landmark embodying the glory of the judicial institution. We are therefore honored to welcome you all in the portal of this magnificent edifice. The presence of Honorable Sri Justice J. Chalmeshwar has added radiance to this inaugural function. Sri Justice Chalmeshwar is known for his great vision for the judicial system as a whole and in particular state judiciary, with the objective of creating a judicial institution which is not only just and fair, but also works towards serving the teeming millions of this great nation. His Lordship is known for his deep and thought-provoking legal analysis and analytical approach to varied legal issues, instilled with a social sensitivity. As a judge of the High Court of Judicature at Hyderabad and Chief Justice of the Guwahati and Kerala High Court, his Lordship left an indelible mark on those institutions. As the judge of the Supreme Court, he has delivered several landmark judgments. His Lordship's dissenting opinion in the NJSC case leaves us with much to ponder upon. His opinion in the privacy matter has added a new dimension to the fundamental rights as we comprehend them, and will be remembered for times to come as one of the most defining moments of the Indian judiciary. The vision of Justice Chalmeshwar for the judicial institution of the country was evidenced when His Lordship constituted a committee by dealing with the matter on judicial side to study the insurmountable pendency of criminal cases in the state of Uttar Pradesh. I welcome you, sir, to the inaugural session of this conference. Honorable Chief Justice R.K. Agarwal is truly a son of this soil and played a stellar role as the judge of this High Court. Throughout his service as Chief Justice of Madras High Court and as a judge of the Supreme Court, His Lordship has continued his associations with this High Court and has been kind enough to advise and guide our path for betterment of the state judiciary. His Lordship is known for his dedication, research-oriented and socialistic approach in decision-making, simple living and maintenance of high standards of office. Your Lordship's presence at this conference raises our spirit. I welcome you, sir, as the guest of honor of this event. Honorable Chief Justice Ashok Bhushan perhaps needs no introduction to any member of the judicial fraternity in this state. An integral member of the institution known as Allahabad High Court and one who started his career in the legal profession from this court itself, His Lordship was known as prolific judgment orders emanating from this court. We are confident that His Lordship's contribution in the Supreme Court will add vision and depth to the jurisprudence of our nation. We are grateful to His Lordship's continued guidance and unstinting support to this High Court. I welcome you, sir, as guest of honor this morning. I extend a warm welcome to all invitees. I also take this opportunity to express special thanks to the government of Uttar Pradesh for extending all help and support for holding this conference in Lucknow. Now let me briefly outline the objective of this conference. People need a strong and effective judiciary that delivers justice effectively and efficiently at affordable cost. This is, in fact, the basic expectation of the people from this institution. The Supreme Court in the third All India judges case had observed, and I quote, "The subordinate judiciary is the foundation of the edifice of judicial system. It is therefore imperative, like any other foundation, that it should become as strong as possible," unquote. The tremendous explosion of docket and pendency of cases at all level has undoubtedly brought the institution under great stress. And therefore, it is often said that the edifice of the judicial Indian judiciary is likely to crumble under its own weight. This has, however, not stopped the inflow of cases. It shows that the people have tremendous faith and confidence in the justice dispensing system in the country, and therefore places upon all of us the obligation and duty to preserve the faith and confidence of the common man has in this institution. This is the core idea for holding this conference. It is our endeavor to impress upon judicial officers in the state the need to rise to the occasion, to inspire them and to prepare them to bear the onerous constitutional responsibility of delivering justice to the people without delay. It is a state, in the state of Uttar Pradesh, as of today, we have about 60 lakh cases pending in subordinate courts and about 9 lakhs in the High Court. It is humanly impossible to decide every case on merits in courts under the normal justice dispensing system. When I took over the reins of this state as Chief Justice, I noticed that about half a dozen pre-1950 cases were pending in different courts of the state together with a large number of pre-2000 cases, not only in subordinate courts but even in High Court. I also noticed that disposal of old cases was absolutely negligible and the courts were more busy in disposing of new cases. My further location had virtually come to stand still in
तो हाईकोर्ट के लखनऊ बेंच में दो दिनों तक न्यायिक अधिकारियों का सम्मेलन शुरू हो चुका है, कॉन्फ्रेंस शुरू हो चुकी है, जहां पर
and enabled me to apprise myself of the problem areas which needed immediate attention, as also those which could warrant review. That also made us to issue specific instructions to all district judges for information relating to old cases and for their disposal on priority. These and other measures have started to bear fruits, and number of old cases, including 3 pre-1950 cases, have been finally disposed of during last few months. These facts are clear evidence of the immense potential of our judicial officers to accept challenges and meet the demands exerted on the institution if they are properly instructed, effectively guided, and meaningfully supported by the High Court. I have so far completed 2 rounds of my personal meeting with the district judges. The judiciary is an institution in this state is presently at the receiving end of criticism from various quarters for a variety of reasons. We have realized the determined focus on alternative dispute resolution techniques, the introduction of judge-mediator concept, issuance of circulars and directions for disposal of old cases on priority to make 5.5+0 reality for the measures are the measures to improve the stature of our institution and change the mindset who perceive the judicial institution to be in the state of limbo and somnolent status quo. I would not like to take much of your time to place steps taken during last 1 year to make ADR and mediation work in this state, since we have a special working session on this topic. But let me inform you all that in order to give added impetus and vigor to ADR and mediation process in particular, we have framed guidelines for according additional credit to referral judges and judge mediators for disposal of every case through mediation. The revamping of credit system is designed not only to enhance but also to improve the output of our judicial officers. Further, the High Court has increased the judicial working hours by half an hour on every working day in the district judiciary. This itself would translate into increasing 27 working days in a year. Similarly, with the consent of district judges, we have amended the rules and stopped practice of performing administrative functions during court working hours. Our endeavor is to see that courts work to the optimum during the judicial hours and to increase the output. In this conference, we have formulated important topics for discussion and interactions, dividing them into four working sessions. The topics you all know. I would like to say a few words only on the topic for discussion in the first working session, namely, exercise of judicial discretion in interlocutory applications and bail applications, and the purpose for its selection. We in the High Court come across the orders of judicial officers passed while disposing of interlocutory applications and bail applications in particular, and we find that most of the applications are rejected for no good reasons. Through this conference, our endeavor will be to develop confidence in our judicial officers to pass orders on merits and as per their conscience without bothering how an appellate or revisional court may receive or review that order when challenged. If judicial officers start passing orders on merits in accordance with law and as per their conscience, they need not carry any fear in mind. I am sure your orders on merits would reduce the huge burden faced by the High Court in dealing with such small matters, and as a result thereof, High Court will be able to focus its attention on more important and long pending cases. Tomorrow, before the valedictory function, we will have a working session on docket management for speedy justice, action plan for zero pendency in 5 years, both civil and criminal. Two senior judges who will be presiding over the said working session have prepared two action plans to make 5+ zero pendency a reality. I am sure the judges participating in the said working session will impress upon the subordinate judges to dispose of old cases and make 5+ zero pendency a reality. To update the legal and procedural performance of the judicial officers at all levels, incidental to this conference, the High Court has published an anthology of articles on selected legal and procedural topics written by sitting and retired judges of the Supreme Court, High Court, and other scholars. This has also been provided to all delegates and participants as study material. I acknowledge the spirited contribution made by editorial and academic committees of our dynamic young judges and the authors for having compiled this book, ensuring that it takes the shape of a handy referencer on topics and issues which confront the members of the district judiciary on a regular basis. The two volumes of the book will be released today in this function. I have merely introduced the theme of this conference in order to make it convenient for the participants to deliberate and with sincerity and listen to the great jurists present today, take guidance from their experience and formulate the roadmap for the expedition to give the people of the state an efficient judiciary. I once again welcome you all, and I request judicial officers to make this 2 days conference a meaningful one, to utilize this occasion for upgrading their skills, standards of performance, enhancement of administrative functions, and above all, to become proactive elements of the judicial system. Let this conference spread a message to the society that judiciary in the state is determined to energize itself and to carry its mantle with reinforced confidence, aiming to achieve and setting even higher standards. Thank you very much.